think a lot of people are happy, but also for the right reasons. These guys performed and performed the right way. And at a critical time, we knew what was going on the last couple of years and how we could have laid down. So just I'm very pleased with the fact that our guys fought through and gave a lot of people a special moment.
Welcome back, folks. For the first time since March the 1st, the University of Hawaii men's basketball team is home. Following a three-week road swing that took them from Northern and Southern California all the way to the school's first NCAA tournament win in Washington, the Big West Conference conquering Bows finally have a chance to unwind and celebrate. After a charter jet back to the 808 from Spokane this afternoon, Bows were greeted with lay and applause upon their return to the Stan Sheriff Center. The travel-weary bunch will now hang banners in the rafters recognizing the team's conference title and first-ever NCAA tournament dub. Now, despite still stinging a bit from the loss to Maryland just yesterday, the players are satisfied, leaving a legacy that will live on forever.
Especially after the kind of the Cal win in the locker room, I was telling everyone, you know, we're going to be remembered for a lifetime and to kind of cherish these moments and this season. We weren't looking at it like an upset or whatnot. So, yeah, everything we've done kind of this season, it's been amazing.
It's real good. You know, like I said, it didn't end the way we wanted it to. It ended, a little sooner than we expected it to. But, you know, just the overall work I think we did as a team this year was really good. We accomplished a lot. You know, we won the most games in school history. So I think that's really important.
The future of Rainbow basketball, I mean, you guys set a standard that hasn't been set before. You feel like the program, this is something that you can build off of in future years?
Absolutely. It's setting the bar. I mean, it's not, it's raising it, but it's setting it. So we have to reach this every year from now on.
As we take a glimpse into next season, future's up in the air as junior Big West Player of the Year Stefan Jankovic, as well as starters Aaron Valdez and Mike Thomas, are all eligible to transfer to any school next year due to NCAA postseason ban in 2017.
Yeah, have you set it like a timeline as far as what you want to do?
Yeah, I'd say before April for myself, yeah. So
what goes into it for you, for your decision?
Talking to my parents, seeing what they'd like to see me do. Also, I mean, myself, talking to the coaches and seeing what their plan is for the future. But it's a long process, so I got to take some time to figure out.
No timetable, honestly. I'm trying to kind of enjoy my time right now in Hawaii. I just got to sit down with my parents. Honestly, that's the only people I'm going to, figure this decision out with. Obviously, it all has to do with the appeal process. And, you know, I'm out the loop on that. I don't know when that's going to be kind of handled or when that's going to be announced. So I guess the timetable would, kind of coincide with when the appeal is. But in terms of myself, I don't want to leave Hawaii. So, I mean, there's no timetable and whatnot.
So the dose of reality now hits with the season all-pow. Senior guards Roderick Bobbitt and Quincy Smith are both all out of eligibility. UH has the possibility of losing their entire starting five if Jankovic, Thomas, and Valdez also all leave the program.
We got it.
Whew. Yikes.
Yeah. Stay tuned.
Yes, exactly.
All right, thanks, Sam.